We are decorated for Advent, as the season of the coming. That's what Advent means. Preparation. You'll hear more about that as we go. Reminder that we ask when you come forward for communion, you wear your mask and sanitize your hands on your way up. There is bread and wafer, whichever you prefer. I will automatically give the bread unless you ask for the wafer. The wine is, the outer rings are red wine. The inner rings are white non-alcoholic wine. So you decide which one you want. Put your empty cups in the trays as you return to your seat. Don't forget the offering plate is in the center of the sanctuary. If you haven't stopped by there, dropped in your offering, please do that. I think that's it for worship. Do we have any prayer concerns? Yes, ma'am. Okay, prayers for the family of Isla's aunt Judy, as Judy has entered the church triumphant. Any others? Yeah. Okay. Keep Ralph in your prayers for actual surgery this week and recovery. Are there other prayer requests? Okay. Let's take a moment and prepare ourselves for worship.
Another chance to turn it all around. And do not save this for tomorrow. Embrace the past and you can live for now. And I will give the world to you. Speak louder than the words before you and give them meaning. No one else has found. The role we play is so important. We are the voices of the underground. And I will give the world to you. Say everything you always wanted. Be not afraid of who you really need. Cause in the end we have each other, and that's at least one thing worth living for. And I will give the world to you. A million suns that shine upon me, a million eyes that yours are the brightest blue. Let's tear the walls down that divide us and build a statue strong enough for two. And I pass it back to you. And I will wait for you. Cause I would give. And I would give the world, and I would give the world to you. This is the new year, a new beginning. You made a promise. You are the brightest. We are the voices. This is the new year. We are the voices. This is the new year.
Please rise as you are able. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Stir up your power, Lord Christ, and come. By your merciful protection, alert us to the threatening dangers of our sins and redeem us for your life of justice. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
promotes it. Let us pray. Stir up your power, Lord Christ, and come. By your merciful protection, alert us to the threatening dangers of our sins and redeem your life for justice. Is this not the prayer we just did? All right. Usually we pray for the candle. Amen. Now you can sit.
First lesson comes from Jeremiah chapter 33. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I have made to the house of Israel and the house of Judah. In those days and at that time, I will cause a righteous branch to spring up for David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In those days, Judah will be saved, and Jerusalem will live in safety. And this is the name by which it will be called: the Lord is our righteousness. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
The second lesson comes from 1 Thessalonians chapter 3. How can we thank God enough for you in return for all the joy that we feel before our God because of you? Night and day we pray most earnestly that we may see you face to face and restore whatever is lacking in your faith. Now may our God and Father himself and our Lord Jesus direct our way to you, and may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we abound in love for you. And may he so strengthen your hearts in holiness that you may be blameless before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his saints. Word of God, word of life.
Gospel according to St. Luke, the 21st chapter. Jesus said, "There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars, and on the earth distress among nations, confused by the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will faint from fear and foreboding of what is coming upon the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. Now when these things begin to take place, stand up and raise your heads, because your redemption is drawing near." Then he told them a parable. "Look at the fig tree and all of the trees. As soon as they sprout leaves, you can see for yourselves and know that summer is already near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that the kingdom of God is near. Truly I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Be on your guard, so that your hearts are not weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and the worries of this life, and that day does not catch you unexpectedly like a trap. For it will come upon all who live on the face of the whole earth. Be alert at all times, praying that you may have the strength to escape all these things that will take place and to stand before the Son of Man." This is the gospel of our Lord. You may be seated. Let the children come to me for our Lord's words. So invite the children present to come forward at this time. Stuff. I haven't even opened it yet. guys like hats? Yeah? What color do you like? Start with you. Silver, green, blue, or red? Silver. Okay, there you go. What color do you want?
Blue.
How about you, Sam? What color do you want? Green, red, silver, or blue? This one? Oh, red. Sorry. There you go. Ooh. All right. Well, then I'm going to have green because then everybody's different. Let's see if this fits on my big head. Ooh. All right. Why do you think we have hats on? I don't know. What do you wear a hat for? Yeah. Birthday parties, right? Whose birthday is it? Nope. Ah, that was a trick question. When is Jesus' birthday party? Christmas, that's right. It's not Christmas. Look, but we're all decorated. What are we decorated for? Advent. You've been listening. Very smart, yeah. It's Advent. I know it looks a lot like Christmas, but it's not really. It's Advent. You know how you can tell the difference? All of the decorations in the sanctuary are blue. And blue is the color of Advent. But what's Advent? Yeah, it is. It's when you count down for Christmas. It's about getting ready for Christmas. But it's also about getting ready for when Jesus will come back. So it's a lot of things. And it is the first Sunday of the church year. Okay, so I'm going to give you a big, fancy word. Can you say liturgical? No. I mean, you can? That's pretty close. Liturgical, yeah, there you go. It's an important word that you'll never have to use. But it's good to know. It's a church word. It means the work of the people. And so in the church, we have these symbolic things that we do to help us remember and learn. And the liturgical church year is, it teaches us about Jesus. And the beginning of the church year is Advent. So it's a new year. So it's time for a New Year's party. One horn. You went for blue. Purple. One. Red. Okay. I don't know how you blow these with a mask. You don't. You don't blow these with a mask, but you can take it back there and blow it during the service. But it's like New Year's. You celebrate New Year's because we're starting all over. We're starting again. Remembering how Jesus comes to us, just like New Year's. And at New Year's, people make like promises and plans for how they're going to live in the new year. And Advent is about being ready for Jesus to come back. So in the new year, we start looking to Jesus coming back to take us with him to be in heaven forever with God. And right now, we also celebrate and get ready for Jesus to celebrate his birthday, right? So, first Sunday of Advent, it's the new year for the church. And we can celebrate and remember that Jesus is coming back for us. And we get ready and we prepare, okay? Let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for coming for us, for being with us, for promising to come back. Help us to look to you in everything we do in this new church year. Amen. All right, you guys can go back to your seats. I'm going to take this off. Sorry. I can't do that. Would you pray with me? Gracious God, we give you thanks for this new church year, for the memory of what you have done for us and for the promise of what you will do. We ask that you send your spirit among us now, open our hearts and our minds, bless the words of my mouth that they carry to your people a sign and the strength to prepare for your coming. In your holy name we pray. Amen. So we had some of this reading already not too long ago, and I said that's one of the things about the liturgical calendar, that there are just some things that work really good in more than one place, and sometimes they back up. And so we hear about this coming of God and the signs that will be seen, and it's a big thing in throughout the Bible, but mostly in the Old Testament. But even Jesus talks about it. We heard it today. You'll see waves and the seas rising, which I think is really interesting, and nations in distress, and all of these things, and you're going to know that Jesus is coming back. But Jesus also tells us, don't worry about it. He doesn't say that in this one. He in another, I'm sure we're going to hear it, because there's 4 weeks of Advent, and we hear a lot of, here are the signs, and God is coming, and Jesus says, you know what, don't watch the signs, it doesn't matter. Don't watch them to, like, understand and figure out the day that it's coming. In fact, he says no one knows, not even the Son knows. So don't worry about that, but he does give us these signs. He says things are happening, and then he says, be ready. Be prepared. That's what Advent is about, as we look toward the coming of the kingdom, toward the coming of Jesus, not just the coming at Christmas. It's not just about getting your house decorated. I keep my tree here. Well, I have many trees. I keep my two big ones here, but I have a small apartment, so I'm only putting one up. So I brought the tree box home last week, and I was like, oh, I need to get it out of my car. So I had to put it up last night so I could get the empty box back. I didn't feel like it. But I did. I got it up. My whole plan was to clean the apartment and to get everything ready to start putting the decorations up. And I got the corner where the tree goes really clean. And the tree is now standing with no ornaments, but it's there, and the empty box is back. Because you got to get prepared, and be prepared. And that's what Advent's about. It's about preparing. It's about getting ready for the big celebration. But it's also, as we hear today, it's about being ready for Christ's coming, no matter what's going on in the world. So Jesus keeps talking about these signs and all these things that are going to change and be signs that God is coming back, that Jesus is going to come in this majestic, like, riding the clouds. It's this amazing picture that we have that honestly probably meant more to them than it does to us, because we have airplanes now, right? So riding the clouds, eh. We have superheroes that do it all the time, eh. I know that they're not real. We have Santa. He rides on the clouds. He's real. But for them, it was this big, majestic entrance. Jesus is going to make an entrance. That's what it tells us, and we have to be ready. You don't want to miss it, which is really interesting to me, because he talks about this big, gigantic entrance, and then he says, make sure you're looking up or you're going to miss it. I don't know. His point is, be looking, be ready. Don't get so focused on the stuff of today, on the craziness out there in the world. Don't be stuck in dissipation. I had to look that up. What does dissipation mean? It means debauchery. It means drunkenness. It means all the things that are super fun in this world, but not really what God wants us to do. Don't focus too much on that. Don't get stuck so much in that you miss the coming of the kingdom, because it's coming. And like I told you a couple of weeks ago, it's coming, and the signs are there, even though the signs have been there for centuries. Ed, you missed this one, because I said, Ed'd like this. In the Civil War, people said, this is brother rising against brother, nation against nation. This is a sign of the coming. And here we are. The signs are out there. And Jesus says, don't get so focused on that. Don't get so worried about that you're like, well, I got to live my life to have fun right now, and you're focused on that, and you're not looking, and you don't see Jesus coming. We have to wonder during Advent if, as Jesus paints this picture, as he says, and the Son of Man will come on the clouds, riding on the clouds, and the picture has always been, the tradition has always been this big, beautiful thing, like just soaring in, and the trumpet will sound, and everybody will hear it, and you can't help but see Jesus coming. And yet, when has God ever done it the way people expect? When has God ever shown up the way the books say he will? I mean, yes, Jesus came like the Messiah. But when Jesus arrived, and we talk about this in his triumphal entry into Jerusalem before he dies, the people expected a warrior king on a giant horse ready to take on all of Rome. And they got a humble carpenter on a donkey, actually the foal of a donkey. Not at all what they were expecting. So when we hear the Son of Man will come in clouds, maybe he's going to come obscured by the clouds. Maybe it's not going to be obvious. Maybe the Son of Man comes into our lives all the time. Now, yes, we still teach that there will be an end time when God will bring everyone together and claim all things back to God. But we hear Jesus say today, heaven and earth will pass away. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will stay forever. My word that is true, my promise to you that you are a saved child of God, that God wants to reconcile the world to God's self. That word of Jesus continues no matter what is going on around us. And maybe, just maybe, the advent of our Lord we see in little things. Maybe, obscured by the clouds, Jesus comes as the one who lends a hand to the neighbor. Maybe, just maybe, Jesus' advent into your life is through a thank you from someone at the food pantry. Maybe, just maybe, and this is a little bigger than the clouds, but if you go downstairs in the basement right now, you might be shocked. The food pantry has moved everything. We have our entire basement empty. And while that's a little bittersweet for some of us, it's also the coming of God's work in this world in such a way that they had to move on to bigger ministry. Maybe that is the advent of God, the coming of Jesus, the Son of Man. A little obscured by the clouds because we're so focused on But they're gone, or we're so focused on, as I'm sure the food pantry people have been, where do we put everything? And weeks ago, we were so focused on, please let this go through. We're so focused on the things of this world that sometimes we miss Advent. God coming into your life. Talk about God breaking into our world, into our lives in all sorts of ways. One of the big ways we talk about God breaking into the world is in baptism, that he breaks into your life very much in the waters of baptism. God breaks in throughout the stories. When Jesus dies on the cross, the temple curtain is ripped from top to bottom. It is a dramatic scene with all kinds of meaning for the people, because God broke loose of how they had him captured, held, protected behind the altar. God broke loose, the curtain ripped from top to bottom as no human could have done it. And God is free in the earth. The advent of God, God coming into your life, is not always big and flashy. Maybe it's in the words of a hymn or a reading. Maybe it's in the lighting of a candle. Maybe it's in the decorations and being back in the sanctuary for this holiday season. Maybe it's a card from an old friend. I've received multiple condolence cards on the death of my mother, obviously, but two that I've gotten in the past week are from people I haven't talked to in years. They took the time to find my address and send me a card. A card? Do you remember cards? You send them in the mail, you put a stamp on it, and they go. Actual cards, not just a Facebook comment, but cards. Maybe that's the advent of God breaking into my life when I most needed it. It happens in your world too. At Advent, liturgically, we simplify, except for us. We decorate in the color of blue, which is besides my favorite color, is a subdued color, but it is the color of hope, the color of looking for the coming of God. So I invite you this Advent to look behind the clouds for the Son of Man arriving in your world, the one who brings the love of God for the universe, for you particularly, into your world. And the one who maybe rides with you and your words and actions into the lives of others. Advent, the coming of our Lord. He will come on the clouds. How's God gonna do that different? Amen. Please rise as you're able. Let us proclaim our faith with the whole church using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. For today's prayers of intercession, we will end each petition with, "Hear us, O God," and invite you to respond with, "Your mercy is great." In this season of watching and waiting, let us pray for all people and places that yearn for God's presence.
God of presence and peace, strengthen your church around the globe to proclaim the message of your love coming into the world. Open our hearts to recognize your face in all people and in all creation. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of mighty redwoods and microscopic plants, fields and city parks, the wind and the waves, be a healing balm to our wounded planet. May we nurture what you have lovingly created. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of equity and compassion, bring righteousness and goodness to all peoples of the earth. Give a heart of discernment and integrity to leaders in our communities. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of comfort and care, be present with those who watch and wait. Come to all who await births, deaths, divorces, new unions, new jobs, retirements, healing, and life transitions of every kind. Especially all we serve through Share Food, Share Love Food Pantry, and everyone on our congregation's prayer list, and those we name silently or out loud now. Hear us, O God. God of promises kept and new dreams awakened, shelter your people from destructive storms. We pray for those whose lives have been upended by natural disasters, for the work of Lutheran Disaster Response, Lutheran World Relief, and other relief organizations. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of companionship and community, we give you thanks for the saints who journeyed with us and now abide in you. Even in distress and uncertainty, make us confident that your promises endure forever. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. God of new life, you come among us in the places we least expect. Receive these prayers and those of our hearts in the name of Jesus. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us share that peace. You may be seated.
Lord, I my vows to
offer the gifts of our hearts and our lives to the service of all your people. Prepare the way before us as we meet you in this simple meal. Through Christ Jesus, our pathway and our peace. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. Fulfilling the promise of the resurrection, you pour out the fire of your Spirit, uniting in one body people of every nation and tongue. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your holy name.
Amen.
Amen. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come to Christ's banquet. Feast on God's gift of grace.
My
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you forever in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. Most High God, you have come among us at this table. By the Spirit's power, form us to be bearers of your word, sharing gifts of mercy and grace with all. Through Christ Jesus, our host and our guest. Amen. The God of hope, fill us with all joy and peace in believing, so that we may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit, through Christ Jesus, for whom we wait. Amen. Personal celebrations today or announcements of any kind? All right. Let's remember who we are. We are a community of disciples embodying the unconditional love of Jesus with a firm commitment to the feeding of body and soul. Okay, I have a couple of things. Oh my gosh. I have a bunch of things. Okay, if you want a calendar from Hitzman Funeral Home, there's some in there and there's some on the table in the Narthex. If you need someone to, if you need it to be sent to your home, let Jill know and she will do that for you. Likewise, the next quarter of our daily bread, so December, January, February, is available again in there and on the table. And there is a special Christmas, 10 Christmas reflections that is also available. Same place. Again, if you want it sent to you, let Jill know and she will send it. And then, as you go out and come in during Advent, the tree in the narthex has, once again, the ELCA Good Gifts ornaments. Those are, if you want to give someone a gift, give someone that has everything a gift, you can buy one of those things in their name. They can have the ornament as a reminder. You do it all online, so those are just some of the options. There's also catalogs available if you want to go and do some of the bigger things. This really goes pretty well hand in hand with our ministry as a church that feeds. They do a lot of feeding through this. You can buy a cow or a chicken or, I don't know, there's a bunch of things. Pigs, goats, latrines. What? You can send a little girl to school. Yeah, uniforms, books. That's not really feeding, but that's okay. There's all kinds of options. This is available throughout the year, but we've been doing it at Advent since they started doing their little ornament things. If you want to do it, you take an ornament from the tree and you either go online, which and all the information would be on the ornament, and pay for it that way, or you can do it through the mail, excuse me, and they will, there's flour in my throat. And they will even give you can print off a little card that says this was given in your name, blah blah blah. It's a really great way to help and to again give gifts to people who have everything. So those are there. Annual meeting is in 2 weeks. That's December 12th. We will do it right after worship. We'll have a shortened version of the service, and we'll do it right here. Do we need to do anything else about that? No, it's announced. I think that's it. Yeah, let's sing.